Hello friends, today we are going to discuss some definitions and notations in graph. First of all, graph. A graph GVU or simply G is defined as a set V of elements Vj where j equal to 1 to etc n, which can be represented as points, and a set U of pairs ordered by Vj Vk where Vj Vk belongs to V, which can be represented as arcs joining points of V. So a graph mainly consists two sets, V and U, where V the set of elements which can be represented as points, and a set U of pairs ordered by Vj Vk which can be represented as arcs joining points of V. Vertices and arcs. The elements of V are called vertices and the elements of U are called arcs. We shall denote the elements of U as either Uy, where I equal to 1 to etc m, or as ordered pair Vj, Vk. Directed graph. If Vj, Vk are ordered pairs, we represent them by directed arcs. That is, arcs carrying arrow marks on them, denoting the direction Vj to Vk. A graph with a directed arcs is called a directed graph. Finite graph. The graph is said to be finite when V and U are finite sets. Initial vertex and terminal vertex. An arc, directed or undirected, is said to be incident with a vertex which it joins to some other vertex. It connects the two vertices. The directed arc UI equal to order per VJ VK is said to be incident from or going from VJ and incident to or going to VK, where VJ is called the initial vertex and VK the terminal vertex of the arc ordered per VJ VK. Now we can go through an example of a graph. Consider this figure. Here the set V consists of the elements V1, V2, V3 up to V9, and set U consists of the elements U1, U2 up to U11. Now consider the arc U4. Here the arc U4 is directed from V2 and directed to V9. And also we can say the arc U4 is incident from V2 and incident to V9. Now we can see that all the arcs in the graphs are directed. So this graph is an example for a directed graph. And also the set V and U are finite. So this graph is also an example for a finite graph. Subgraph. A subgraph of GVU is defined as a graph G1, V1, U1 with the V1 subset of V and U1 containing all those arcs of G which connect the vertices of G1. Consider the figure 1. Let V1 equal to set V1, V2, V3 and U1 equal to set U1, U3, U2. Then this is a subgraph of this graph. Partial graph. A partial graph of GVU is a graph G2 VU2 which contains all the vertices of G and some of its arcs, that is U2 subset of U. That is, in this figure we can erase some of the arcs, then this is become a partial graph of the original graph. Let V1 and V2 be two subsets of V such that they have no common vertex, and let UI equal to ordered pair VJ VK be an arc such that VJ belongs to V1 and VK belongs to V2. Then UI is said to be incident from or going from V1 and incident to or going to V2. It is incident with both V1 and V2 and is said to connect them. For example, let V1 equal to set V2, V3 and V2 equal to set V9, V6. Then the arc U4 is said to be connects V1 and V2. Now we can go through some notation used in graph. Omega Vk. The set of arcs of GVU incident with a subset Vk of V. Omega plus Vk. The set of arcs incident to Vk. and omega minus vk, the set of arcs instant from vk. Now consider this graph. Let v1 equal to set v2, v3. Then omega plus v1, that is the set of arcs instant to vk, u1 and u5. And omega minus v1, that is set of arcs instant from vk, that is u4, u2, u6. And now omega v1, the set of arcs of GVU instant with a subset vk of v, which is the union of this omega v1, and omega plus v1 and omega minus v1, that is u1, u5, u4, u2, u6. Now, chain. A sequence of arcs u1, u2, etc., uk, uk plus 1, etc., uq of a graph such that every intermediate arc uk has one vertex common with the arc uk minus 1 and another common with the uk plus 1 is called a chain. For example, consider this figure. Here the sequence u2, u3, u4, u7 forms a chain. It may also be denoted as sequence v1, v3, v2, v9, v6. Cycle. A chain becomes a cycle if in the sequence of arcs no arc is used twice and the first arc has a vertex common with the last arc and this vertex is not common with any intermediate arc. For example, consider this figure. Then the sequence u3, u5, u7, u4 is a cycle. It may also be denoted as v2, v3, v6, v9, v2. Path. A path is a chain in which all the arcs are directed in the same sense, that is in the same direction, such that the terminal vertex of the preceding arc is the initial vertex of the succeeding arc. For example, the sequence u1, u3, u6, u9 is an example for a path. It may also be denoted as v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. A path is a chain, but every chain is not a path. Now, circuit. A circuit is a cycle in which all the arcs are directed in the same sense, that is, they have same direction. For example, the cycle u1, u3, u2 is an example for a circuit, and the cycle u9, u8 is also an example for a circuit. Connected graph. A graph is said to be connected if for every pair of vertices there is a chain connecting the two. For example, figure 1 is not connected because there is no chain connecting, for instance, v6 to v7 and v2 to v8. If we erase the vertices v7, v8 and the arc u11, we shall be left with a connected graph. Component of the graph. If VA is a vertex of a graph, then the set formed by VA and all other vertices which are connected to VA by chains and the set of arcs connecting them form a component of the graph. A connected graph has only one component. If a graph is not connected, it has at least two components. For example, consider figure 1. Here the graph has two components, one consisting of vertices v7, v8 and the arc u11, and the other the remaining portions. Tree. A tree is defined as a connected graph with at least two vertices and no cycles. A tree with n vertices has n minus 1 arcs and that every pair of vertices is joined by one and only one chain. Consider figure 2. This is an example for a tree. Center. A vertex which is connected to every other vertex of the graph by a path is called a center of the graph. A graph may or may not have a center or may have many centers. Consider figure 3. Here, this vertex is considered as a center of this graph. Thank you.